It's Wednesday, Klaus here. It's time for another basic DaVinci Resolve tutorial.
Hello, Klaus here. It's Wednesday and time for yet another basic DaVinci Resolve tutorial. In this episode, it's going to be all about composition of your shot using DaVinci Resolve. So the basic rule when doing composition, when you are filming, is the rule of thirds. So a lot of cameras, like the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema cameras, do have a built-in rule of third guidelines to how to do the composition of your shots. But sometimes you didn't shoot the footage, and the ones who didn't use the rule of thirds. So how can you use the rule of thirds inside of DaVinci Resolve? So first off, we need to actually make the rule of thirds so we can work with it. So how to do that? We'll do that by going up to the effects. I'll go into the effects and I'm going to take an adjustment clip. I'm going to put that down here on my clip with the lights here, and I'm just going to extend this a little bit, like so. Then I'll go into my open effects. I'm going to search for grid. And we have the grid right here. I'm going to put the grid effect onto the adjustment clip. And I'll go up to the inspector. And in here, I have now a lot of squares. I want to make this way less. So in row cells, I want to make that into 3. For columns, I want to do the exact same, like that. And that's all I want to do. So now I have built my line of thirds, and the basic rules of that is to either put your subjects around this corner here, or actually on these lines. So that's what we're going to do for now. I'm going to select my clip here underneath, and let's say I'm going to zoom that in a bit, and I'll move it up and position it to the side, something like that. So if that was my center of attention, I'm pretty sure that this clip would be more interesting than it was before. We can also try to do the same thing. I'm just going to make the clip a little longer here, or the adjustment clip longer. We can do the same here. So in theory, this is done very well, but let's say we want to change it, or we want the focus to be here. We could do the same thing again by zooming in our clip and readjusting if, for instance, this is what we want. Of course, this is a pretty nice composition, but there's a lot of empty space, so you wouldn't probably do it like that. Maybe we would move it here instead. Something like that. Depending on what you want to show, of course. I mean, that is totally up to you, but this is like the basic of how to use the rule of thirds and how to apply it into DaVinci Resolve. Also, there's a trick more, of course. So now we have done an adjustment clip. So if I go up to the file name here, I can actually change this name to rule of third. Rule of third, yeah. And I can change the color to something else. And now I can take this thing, and if I have opened up my, just go back to my media pool here, I have my smart bins. You can find those up under view, and all the way down here we have show smart bin or show power bins. And in fact, if we use the show power bins, I'm going to open up my power bins, and I can take this and add into my power bins into the master, and then I have this. And if I open my power bin again and drag it down, I have my rule of thirds here. The only thing that doesn't come back when you do it like this is the color, but I think that is a DaVinci thing more than anything else. So that is how we can easily add in the rule of third into DaVinci Resolve 17. Just remember to delete the clip before you do the render, if you don't want to have the rule of third rendered out, of course. I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.